I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places.
So now we'll be moving on to the stick form of lipstick. First, I guess we'll start off with our classic Revlon brands lipstick. This one is the Black Cherry. This one has been unused. It's pretty shiny. But for how long? I don't know. I like the dark red lipstick, so. And since this one's considered, this brand's a kind of a drugstore makeup, I could find that CVS, Ulta, but CVS is one, Walmart, kind of anywhere. And this one is Violet Frenzy. I think this one's a shimmer. If you can tell. I think this is one of the few purple lipsticks I have, actually. I think it's, well, maybe it used to be more of a rare thing, or not common. Now, maybe it is. I know they have some blue lipstick going out there. But since purple is my favorite color, it would only make sense to have that in my makeup. Or this one's called Cherries in the Snow. This one, I assume with Christmas snow, but it's like a bright red, almost, well, not holly berry, but cherry for cherry, but still you think of Christmas specifically being, you know, that red from the red and green colors. These are so shiny. I don't even want to use them because then they won't be shiny anymore. And then, did I say dark cherry? I have two black cherries, so, and I think they're both unused. Meaning I've gotten these before, but I just haven't gotten around to using either of these two yet. But I love the Black Cherry. That's, for me, that is a classic one. Another one that I love the shade, but have never used before, is Mauvey Night. So you can tell I'm kind of, I like the dark shades of red, and I only go up until a certain lightness or light shade. So, and part of it is my skin tone, but naturally I just prefer like the darker kind of muddier reds. think they just contrast better with my skin. And then we have, oh, our third black cherry. This is why I'm not buying it, like, for a long time, because I have three of these. Yeah, and they're all unused, which, in one way, that's good. And then the one that is a classic, and I have broken this out. I'm kind of surprised I don't have another one of these, but I think I decided the Mauve Night was so similar to this that I don't know if I would really buy this one again, but this shade is called Rose Velvet, and I have used it, so... I'm gonna compare this, the Rose Velvet and the Mauve Night, and we'll see. So clearly they are different, but I'm thinking this one might be a slightly cooler tone, and this one's more on the warm side, but yeah, I have so much lipstick that I don't think I would get another one of these, even though I really like the color. I may keep the tube, or at least write down the shade to remind myself that the Rose Velvet is deemed as a Jasmine classic, but for now it will just be waiting to be used up. And then I think that's it for the Revlon line. This next one I've probably used quite a bit. This was from a I think in a lower beauty box. And this one is by Shiseido. You don't see the boxy square tubes as much. Here's the symbol. This one's called Exotic Red, which I love. You can tell. Because it's so worn down, but yeah, it's a really nice shade of red. But I have, when you realize this, I have so many shades of red that while they kind of all sometimes look the same, but this tube I will probably keep just for the sake of it. It's the only Shiseido thing I have, I believe. Okay, so then these are NYX, NYX, I'll call it. What is this? This one's called Red Hot. My aunt gave me these unused. I think she don't know if these were from a beauty box or she got them and then she never ended up using them, but brand new, slightly on the cool tone, like, well, classic red. But if I'm going to compare this, or maybe on a warm, cooler warm tone, whatever, if I'm going to compare this to the other one she gave me, same line, except this one is called Cherry Charm. And make note of these two caps. If I'm going to compare them, I would probably say that maybe it's not a matter of warm and cool tone, but the lightness of the shade. Whereas this one's lighter. The Cherry Charm is lighter than the Red Hot. So, just looking at the cap preview, sometimes it doesn't really tell all. So just kind of to open it and see what exactly the shade is you're looking at. I didn't realize this. I have a lot of NYX guys over here. So, this one is more like, they call it butter. I guess it's from the butter line. Like a smoother lipstick, but it's tinted. This one is called Lifeguard. So like Lifeguard Red. It's a different bottle. This one's similar, except it's a little bit smaller than the last one, the Lifeguard one. This one is called this one's called Eden. I don't know if this one is matte. I assume it has some shine. This Lifeguard one might be some shine, however, this one's, I think, the matte kind. Yeah. Okay. It's a little baby, it's a mini one. It's like same concept, but a lot smaller. I mean, this shade, well, after a while they all look the same, kind of, but this one reminds me of Revlon's Cherries in the Snow. These are NYX, even though they're the liquid lipstick, I guess I'll do these next, because pretty much I've almost covered all the stick versions, so these are the liquid ones, but I think two of these two, okay, so these two are on the same line. These are butter gloss. This This one's called Cranberry Pie. I've never used these before, so this is my first time opening them. It's like a slightly purple, which is nice. And then this one is called Sorbet. So these were from an Ulta box, by the way. Beauty boxes are everything. Okay, so definitely a lighter shade. I could think of a strawberry sorbet color. I guess I kind of avoid the popular girl lipstick shade, which is, I'd say hot pink, usually. Either hot or like a really bright pink, or even a pastel, which is really ultra light shade. Because when I'm not a popular girl, I'll never be a popular girl. Or like popular / mean girl lipstick shades. Like, because when I'm neither of those, and most importantly, they do not contrast well with my skin tone being kind of medium-ish, medium to light. Yeah. So, no light shades here. And if I come across one, it's going to be because I just decided to give it a try. I'm staring at that one lip pencil over there on the corner. We'll get to that. So, this is a different line. This one's a soft matte metallic. And these are actually lip creams. So, not the same as liquid lipstick, but kind of works the same way, I bet. This one's called California. And then this one is these are the same shade. These are both California. I guess we got duplicates. Except this one is metallic and this one is the matte version. These are a lighter shade, but I guess these were the ones I thought I would give a try. And plus they were free. Somebody gave them to me from their beauty box, so I thought I would hold on to them for now. I think this is the last NYX lipstick product, except this is a lip gloss. It's clear. It's obviously what kind of name they're peddling it by. Brillo. See, even if it's clear, they have a fancy name for it. And I assume this is under the lingerie line, which I, like, contrary to popular belief right now, all of these NYX things I've shown you, I've never gone to the store and bought. It's the magic of beauty box samples. So, from other people, So, I have them, but honestly, I'm not that much of an expert on them. Then I didn't see these until now, but these are the two Revlon lipsticks that I have in liquid format. So this one is called, let's see, Desert Spice. And then this one is Shimmer. It's called the Gloss Super Lustrous. This one's called Rose Quartz. I noticed this is kind of a thicker makeup or lipstick, lip gloss pad brush. Usually they're a little bit smaller. So lighter pink, but I think being it a kind of a slightly translucent, being a lip gloss, I'm fine with that. It's just like the direct lipstick being super light that it looks awful on me. And I have two of these. They're like, I mean, they could be used for foundation or any kind of gel or cream, but I've used these mainly for sometimes the lip balm and the lip tints in the jar, or I have an eye mask in a jar too, but I kind of just keep it in the same drawer. And then this one, I think it was from a sample, but I kept the brush. This is the official lip balm brush that I would use for those lip balms in a tin or in a jar. Everything's falling. But I think that's normal. There's always some kind of avalanche, as Mod Made would say. Everything's falling and an avalanche is bound to happen. So gonna go on like because nothing's happening. I have so many, like, I need to organize. I didn't have this part, I didn't have organized I'm a personal organizer. I guess I can't really go by brand now. I forgot. Okay, my last NYX lip gloss or liquid lipstick is this neat bottle. What's the packaging? It's like, I don't, holographic, kind of, if I, it's a better view. It's called hashtag this is everything. It's a lip oil. So I didn't want to say lipstick, but I've never used a lip oil. Like, I didn't know. I mean, I'm sure I knew, but, like, the concept of lip oil didn't cross my mind ever, so. It looks like a lipstick, so. Probably just, unless there's instructions on here, I'll probably just treat it like liquid lipstick. This one is called Sheer Berry. But I like the holographic look to it. And then I guess I'll just tie in lipstick with liquid lips. So there's the lipstick version and then the liquid lipstick. I think they're still, they're different colors, but for some reason, I think these were both sold around the holidays. And so snowflakes and the stars. This one's called Immortal. And what's cool about this is that all these pretty snowflakes are carved into the actual lipstick. I always like that, the little engravings to make it fancy before you use it and then ruin everything. kind of makes you not want to use it because it's so pretty, and then you're gonna smudge it all over and then ruin the design. But yeah. Then this one is called Tender Trap. And I was kind of confused. This is the Pure Color Envy, must be the line. But this one is Tender Trap. And both of these are by Estee Lauder. So this is the liquid version of this shade. I feel like this is a thinner tip brush. I have, this one's called Stilla, by Stilla, Stay All Day Liquid Lipstick, by Stilla Cosmetics. This one is called Bezo. Let's see. I think this is, yeah, definitely the sample size. So probably from Beauty Box, because it's the power of Beauty Boxes. So. Sugar Coat by Sugar Rush. This one it's Velvet Liquid Lipstick. I think this one's called Sprinkle. So we have a candy sweet treat thing. Theme going on. Another sample. Hence the baby size. Oops. It's actually, I feel like it's actually a darker shade than the bottle. Of course, the bottle being not see-through, but you can tell. I think this is the only one I have of this, but this is by Pacifica, Natural Minerals. This is from the Enlightened Gloss Nourishing Mineral Lip Shine line. This one is called Poppy. I remember getting this at, I think, Sprouts Farmers Markets. or we just call it Sprouts, which is where my dad used to work as a janitor. He had a lot of funny stories working at Sprouts. So it was funny going in there and then, like, and all the employees, like, waving hi at you. I kind of laugh at it now because it's funny to think like that. But I guess when you have even a parent working there and, like, everybody recognizes you because chances are they watched you grow up, as they did for me. Like, in my case, like, I was really young when my dad started working there, so... So it says lip shine. Same, this is like a shimmer. This one I never used before. I mean, a lot of these things I haven't used because I'm too busy using up other stuff, but I guess this would be the perfect time to make this video just because a lot of stuff is nice looking and not all smudged up. And I'm having a problem with my camera focusing. It's definitely the exposure, but you can see it. From what I can tell, there's a little bit of shimmer in there. And speaking of shimmer, we have our Too Faced Watermelon Candy Finish Lip Gloss. And let's see, this one is called Bump and Rind. So it's like a watermelon design, which I love. I mean, this is like watermelon lover fantasy, kind of. I like the nice metallic green. It's hard to tell with just the brush, but you can kind of see the shimmer. And I think we'll get to this. We'll come back to this a little bit later, just because I have a liquid eyeshadow. It's just, you'll recognize the same shape of bottle. Not from the same line, but that Too Faced brand can be quite recognizable, even if it's for a whole nother area of the body or face. Anyways, this is something I've never heard of, like, both the brand and this concept, at least for the cheek. But I could see it being a little bit popular, but I'm thinking more, when I think of cheek tint, I'm thinking of, like, historical, but maybe now it's kind of coming back into play. But this is called Juice Pot by The Beauty Crop. And it's a lip and cheek tint. It's called Melon. And this is sample. This is another one from the beauty boxes. I think this was the Walmart beauty box. Even though I've never seen this on Walmart, but like, I want to say this is kind of a orangey tone, even though it's melon, but I feel like cantaloupe melon isn't this dark, but it is handy that the brush, I guess it's different, like, seeing this as a cap, because it looks like, this reminds me of a nail polish brush connected to the lid, but it has to accommodate for this unique, like, bottle jar shape. Because usually lipsticks and lip glosses are usually in tubes. This is the only thing I have in the lip department with this type of container. I'm sure maybe people that are more makeup enthusiasts will have like different types of things that I've never even heard of also, but just like, except for the liquid lipstick, which I am fond of. I'm kind of a little bit more old school, maybe. I don't know. I honestly don't keep up to date in the makeup world just because that's not my livelihood, and I don't, because I have reasons not to really focus on as much, because I'm not actively buying makeup, because you can see why I'm on overload. But it's whatever I come across in these beauty boxes. So this one is a liquid lipstick. It's under the line Kissable by 𝒞𝓇𝒹𝒾𝓉𝓈 Professional. I like this little striped cap, and then the elephant is cute. And this one is called Mad About Mauve, which I love mauve. I think that's the correct term to say, to state whenever somebody asks me what is my favorite type of shade as far as lipstick, but even eyeshadow maybe. And then this one is shimmer. It's by the company, or the line, company line. It's hard to tell because I swear I remember getting this at Dollar Tree, so it's like, I don't really know what brand to look for, but it's, it says flower, and it's under the line Galaxy Glaze Holographic Lip Gloss. And I do like the constellation pattern in the whole rose gold theme. And then, let's see, this one is called Soleil, which is sun in French. So, like, solar system theme, which I love. I was all for this, and seeing this at Dollar Tree, I was like, this looks, like, I've never used this or opened it, but when I bought this for, at the time, like, it was $1, and I thought this was pretty good for $1. Let's see. Can definitely see the shimmer, and again, it's like a light pink, but that's okay because it's just being applied as a lip gloss, and chances are the top coat, usually if I have a matte lipstick, yeah, I'm gonna add a shiny top coat on. And I think these are my last three Shimmer Shine liquid lipsticks. So these are under the brand Anastasia. By Beverly Hills. I don't know if this is for the movie, but I forgot when I don't remember the exact year when I bought these, but they're not too old, but. They're pretty bottles, and I like this the braided design, like the border. Sometimes I say Anastasia, and then like other people will say Anastasia. If I'm correct in thinking it's Russian, but keeping that in mind, And some people say Anastasia, Anna, I'm thinking Anna being with two N's, but honestly, it doesn't matter how you say it, it's at this point. I'm just gonna say Anastasia, but that's what I've been going by almost, so. They're all shimmer. This one is. Oh, and then they did come in a set of three, which is why I have them all together. I think these were at Ulta. Again, I don't really know the year. But This one is called Phantom, which, surprise, that's the one for the red. I'm thinking white, but yeah, I love these shades. I mean, this one I've used a bit. This one not so much, but once I use up other stuff, I will get down to using these too. I think I love the metallic liquid lipstick. That's my favorite. I had one, I forgot the brand, but I think it was getting too old, but I loved it, and I always used it when I did the Queen of Hearts look, and I did the heart-shaped lips, and it looked perfect for that. This one is more of a bronze-ish, slightly rose gold. This one is called, Mai Tai, I think. I think it's Mai Tai. Mai Tai, Mai Tai. That was a close call of an avalanche. Mai Tai. This is the problem with me. I can't pick one. Mai Tai is the shade. This is why this video is going to be so long. I'm sure somebody will let me know if this was for the movie or, I think it's the Fox Century, maybe? Yeah, the Fox Century movie, animated film. If that's what the line is for, or maybe it's just the name, I don't know. It can be a common name. Maybe because of that, they're singing it with royalty, and this is why they have it all fancy, and especially fancy, and shimmers are incredible. I love this. This one's called Blizzard, hence the white. I love this Blizzard because you probably can't see it in the camera if I move it down like a little. Let's see. If you could see the shimmers, it's like a purple, like a violet purple tint in the glitter shimmer. It's hard to tell. Just like put it on here. So now you can really see it. I think the violet shimmer. So, And if I spread it, I wiped it, and then when I spread it out, it's, you're just left with the glitter, so. Because even if the lipstick wears off, you still have glittery lips. I think I'm down to the, just the stick, the solid version, the solid lipsticks, I'll say. So this one is by Clinique, as I can tell. And also I got it, this is from a kit that I got for, I think, Christmas, from my other pair of aunt and uncle. They're back in, living in Michigan, and they visit, or less frequently, they're coming here now, but they used to visit here in Arizona for like every Christmas, and two times they came here for Easter, but usually they would come here for Christmas, my aunt and uncle, in Michigan, and they got this whole Clinique set for me. I will show, I have a box here, it's one of their signature fragrances, but as far as makeup, this was one of the lipsticks. What is this name? This one's called, wow, I have a hard time reading. This one's called, because I'm relying on the camera, Dramatically Different. Like, I wanted to say dramatically perfect. Is it Dramatically Different lipstick? I think that's supposed to go with, I'll show it later, but there's this Dramatically Different moisturizing cream that it came with too, so it's probably the line. The line is Dramatically Different, so. Surprised that this is a really dark, quite dark of a shade for this bright bottle. What's interesting is in the middle, probably can't tell, but it's a white shimmer, slightly. So I never tried this, I don't know how that's gonna look when you apply it, but we'll see. This is also part of, it was part of that kit, the Clinique one. This one is called Bear Pop. So I assume this is from Clinique Pop. It's like ColourPop line. But more so being like the, not nude colors, but like bear, or sometimes I think bear is also just another term for like nude shades. That's another thing I'm not into, because God, that looks awful on my skin. But this one actually, to me, it's not like a nude shade. It's a really pretty pink, mauve-y pink shimmer. So I don't know where the bear is in that, but... It is called an intense lip base. So... I don't know much about it, but only thing that I know is that it was part of that kit. Now I do know one lipstick I have that's pretty much on the bare or nude shade, nude tones, I guess, are the, or I have two of these, but, the MAC, M-A-C, the MAC lipsticks, or at least one of them is the nude shade, the nude tone one. I think it's this one. This one is, I think they're both matte, except this one is called Velvet Teddy, and I like that it's in the shape of a bullet. But you can see why it's kind of like a nude shade, kind of too light for me, but these were samples, and I liked the bullet shape so much that I kept both of them. So I've tried this one before, and it's like, at least it's not lighter than the shade of my lips. It's kind of about the same, so it doesn't look super bad. But in the end, I'll probably just keep one of these containers. This one is called All Fired Up. Specifically, retro matte lipstick. So this one's definitely more of a red, which I like. Slightly on the cool tone. So then I have this miniature sample of lipstick. However, there is no name. I couldn't find a color name on this, but this is by Yves Saint Laurent. Sometimes I think I use Yves Montand, just like I use a knowledge of that just to help me remember the correct pronunciation. For some reason, I guess. Because, like, I know that name better because of the old Hollywood movies, so. Yeah, and even though I've done French class sometimes, and especially now because I'm not in there anymore, because I've done the highest level that the school has allowed, which is only French 3. I thought, well, for my senior year, I'm not going to retake French 3. I already mastered it, but especially now since I'm not really exposed to as much French content, I have to keep myself um updated, and I have to, like, remember to not forget how to say things, I guess, or to get unused to French names, so that's one way I remember it. But just a classic red. Beauty box power. So, here's another beauty box baby. This is, I've never seen this brand before, I don't think. Anaheim Shine. Is that, I assume Anaheim Shine is the color shade, and it's by Original Recipe, unless I'm wrong. Or that's the line, sorry. And then, so Original Recipe is the line. I'm not familiar with this, but GXVE. It's another boxy tube, which it's another classic red. I like this shade of red is like my favorite, as well as the mauve-y ones, but the, like, not so much the brightness, but, like, the deepness, the saturation, the deepness of the shade of red pops really well. And then this one, I believe, I think it's from Beauty Box. So, but I don't remember which one it's from. This one is called En Mocha. This is the Ultimate Lipstick Love Line by Becca. I mean, I want to say this is probably the full size. So, it's, to me, it's a different tube. Maybe because it's a lot, like, bigger compared to, it's, and it's like kind of weighted. The cap is a little bit different because it kind of looks like a magnet, but I love this tube. It's very metallic, whereas most are like they have some black on them or usually made of plastic nowadays, but I think this is like a tin type of material. It's cool. I would say this is a mauve-y shade. So, like a rose velvet mauve-y. Kind of similar to that Revlon one. And actually, as I did this, so yeah, that's a really good, it is magnet. It's like a magnetic snap, which that's cool. And then I have, this one is, I mean, it's lipstick, but sometimes they call them lip crayons. This one's called Fresh. Extreme Velour Extreme Matte Lipstick. This one's by Laura Mercier. So yeah, this is what they call lip crayon. Skinnier, but kind of same concept as regular lipstick. So this is, they call it lip crayon, but I consider this a lip pencil. But it's by Boxum. It's called, this one's called Hush Hush. And it's a plumpling lip liner. So it's kind of that mauve-y shade, rose velvet mauve-y shade. Let me close it. You can't force this one too much because I just noticed the little cracks. So I can only push in that much. And then on the other end is, like a brush, a smoothing brush. I think this one you'd have to have a separate sharpener for this one. So there's that. And then I have this lip pencil is... This one's by 𝒞𝓇𝒹𝒾𝓉𝓈Cosmetics. And this one's called Bear. So, you notice this one's it looks like a light pink, but since it's just kind of outline and shade in the lips, I think it'll be fine for me. Yeah, I feel like just for shading in little areas, it shouldn't, like, look bad with my skin tone. And this lip pencil is also by 𝒞𝓇𝒹𝒾𝓉𝓈. This one's called Cabernet, and it's more of a red shade. So I have used this one a few times. And I will compare it with the Bear one. So you can see definitely more red and slightly cool tone compared to the Bare one, which is more on the warm side. I know the warm tone and cool tone kind of plays a role as in purchasing makeup depending on your skin tone.
Be seeing you in all the old familiar places that my heart and mind embraces. All